I think these days belts get handed out really easily for all these different titles. This is in place of a trophy. You're not some sort of champion. You've won an eight man.
Yep.
It's a fair call for a belt.
Yep. And you know, Sai has been very passionate about that subject as well.
Yeah. Swapping hands.
Beautiful start from both boys.
They both want to get early night so they can get on to the next one.
Yep. You know, picking the benefits of fighting first in a nightmare, if you're getting biggest the job rest. Done early, yep. biggest rest.
Yep. First fight up, try and get the knockout done quickly. Yep. Beautiful left kicks there. Very even start.
A lot of back and forth.
Yeah. Jack throwing heavy left legs. Pretty happy to throw the heavy hands.
Yeah.
Josh's hands are very, very strong.
Aren't they?
He's got the Muay Thai style body, like standing there nice and strong.
Yeah.
Big legs on him. It looks like he could be a leg kicker. Big knee from Josh. This is phone box style.
Yeah.
This is like in the phone box, just punching on.
Strong right hand from Josh lands. Didn't seem to bother Jack too much.
Look at this, four fights, guys. These guys have had four fights each. This is ridiculous.
Yeah, you've seen worse main events, haven't you? Big combo there from Jack.
This
catches to the body. Jack tying Josh up in the corner here.
Josh looking the stronger of the two. Here's a cut. Someone's cut. There's blood.
Yep.
Josh got blood down the front of him.
Yep.
Who is it? Or is it a nose?
It is Josh, I think.
Josh got his eyes closing up. His nose is bleeding. That's all. It's just a blood nose. But his eyes starting to close up. So also, you can also have an injury problem where you can't continue on in a... If that eye blows up to about, the doctor may say no for him to move forward, which then it leaves, you know, if it came down to him winning this one, then Jack gets to move forward anyway.
That's right.
So people would like to, you know, talk about it. Say, oh, why does someone get to move forward? They didn't win. Well, they kind of did. They came out unscathed.
Yep.
It's a win in its own in a tournament.
You're right. It is that left eye on Josh, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's starting
to swell
up.
Worn an overhand right. The joys of fighting in eights.
Yeah. Yes, that's right. Yeah. Yeah, not too forgiving the smaller gloves.
Big elbows there from Jack. That rear elbow is landing a treat and a big left body kick.
We really have come to love that front leg kick to the body from Jack. He's been throwing it in a lot of his fights and it lands a lot and hard as well.
Oh, swinging out the back. He's landing at will at the moment.
Yeah.
He's so much speed. But once again, faith in his chin. Not panicking so he doesn't lose range.
Yep.
That's why he's landing every shot he throws. Nice step up there in the round from Josh. Yeah,
very
beautiful.
Nice. Very nice from both boys. Yeah. Josh wore a little bit of damage, I think, in that round, but it did nothing to hurt his confidence. You know, still standing toe-to-toe, pushing forward in the ring. Really good round from both guys. You know, Jack picking his shots well, certainly. And we have come to love that from Jack. Like I said, it's that front kick that finds its home. Strong right hand as he forwards in as well. Yeah, it's a beautiful style Jack's got. And really both boys, you know, the strong dominant style.
Yeah. They started trading, but it seems Jack just started piling it on a little bit.
And his confidence grew through that first round as well, didn't he?
Going out for round number two. The longer this goes on, the more energy they use, but also the more banged up they get. Once again, they're fighting again. One of these guys is fighting again. You don't want to be too smashed up going into that next one, where you stop thinking, I don't really want to throw that right kick because my leg hurts or whatever. I fought in eight mans. They suck.
Yep.
My third, fourth, and fifth fights were in an eight man in Darwin. I got through to the final and got knocked out the first round of the final. But I was so smashed up from that show.
Yeah, we've had some absolutely sensational eight-mans right here on Rebellion Muay Thai in the future. And you see the guys just coming out for that last fight. Oh, they look like they've been hit by a truck, don't they?
Yeah, I had the privilege of being in the corner with Semaphat.
Yes.
When he lost the final to Singh Piak.
Yep.
And Singh Piak's face was like falling apart. Like,
wasn't it? Yeah,
massive
that black
eye
was covered,
from his first fight with Denipar. Yeah, that reply with the left body kick from Jack is beautiful.
Yeah.
Really whips his hip around. He's got like those long legs, high hips.
Throws it in.
Yeah. He's got faith in his IQ as well. He can stand there and wait for
the
reply.
Timing is good, isn't
it? Yeah, it is. Waiting to do the reply. Reacting as Josh comes in. I'm saying that, Josh has landed a left body kick of his own.
Yep.
I believe there's nothing more beautiful than someone fighting on the back foot.
Yeah, yep. And, you know, one of those names that comes to mind, Carter Lawrence, of course.
Yeah,
you know,
sure.
Does that so
100%.
Well.
Yeah, 100%.
Who, mind you, think we have the pleasure of seeing tonight at Rebellion Muay Thai?
For sure.
Both boys standing right in front of us here in the commentary. Josh holding the ring nicely, sort of putting a bit of pressure on Jack. Jack doesn't seem to be too bothered.
He has such a strong build, Josh does.
Yeah.
He's got that very like Muay Mutt style, walk forward, punch, kick. You know, it might take a little bit of time to develop that in himself. But, man, he's got all the skills there.
Yeah. Big, heavy kicks.
Yeah.
Strong hands.
It's hard to believe these two guys are in the same weight division.
Is it? Yeah. Yeah, Josh, the noticeably bigger looking of the two, for sure.
Maybe had a bigger cut.
Oh, very nice. Very nice.
That was stunning.
Yeah.
Now Josh is getting the replies.
This has been a good round for Josh.
It has. Definitely rallying back.
Yeah. Both boys tying up here. Josh looking the stronger in the clinch. Jack gets
turns
the turn.
Jack, yeah.
Very nice. We'd like to see a few knees. There it is.
Nice strong exchange there in the clinch. Battling for position. Very even there in the clinch. Both were good. Both going for turns. Beautiful. That was a what you have to do, and you only do that. If it should be enough for you to win. That was a beautiful block into teep there for Jack. Josh back on the front foot, pushing forward. Jack not quite landing that reply now.
Yeah, he almost seems a bit unsure of the distance, doesn't he?
Yeah. He maybe needs to switch instead of just putting his leg back and then kicking up with that left leg, like that
good
one there.
Good kick exchange.
See, if you switch to reply, you get a chance to close the gap when they try to escape you.
Yeah, versus just throwing the leg up.
Kick for kick. Jack, wearing those leg kicks. One thing you don't want to be doing tonight, man. You get your leg hurt in the first fight.
Yeah, it's going to make for a long night, isn't it?
It is. Big body kick, absolutely.
Yeah. Josh looking for the leg kick, really find it, but follow up to the body and finds a home.
Both super skilled boys, once again.
Yeah.
It's not very often you get like five fights into a card and everyone has been good.
Yeah, it's been
you have to have had at least one spastic by then.
And I haven't seen one yet.
Not enough.
No. Everyone in center ring so far, just a great display of that beautiful Muay Thai, which both Roots and Rebellion has come to be known for.
It's important. It's important. Yep. And Sai knows that.
Yep.
Sai prides himself on that.
And Pinky, you've done that, but many of the people both here tonight and listening to the stream would have never seen. When you're walking out of the Rebellion or Roots Muay Thai corner, you're faced with a beautiful testimonial on plaque, displayed beautiful Muay Thai with a picture of Jordan.
Jordan Coe.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're just talking about him today, actually.
And, you know, if you do nothing more, put on a show that and a display of technique that Jordan would be proud of.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, 100%. 100%. Ooh, big rear kick there from Jack. Josh is not quite landing. This has been another seesaw fight.
Yeah, back and forth, back and forth.
You know, it comes down to a third round. You've got to make it stick. You've got to make it look good.
Josh has been favouring that low kick to counter Jack's going to the body.
He has. You can see the reddening. It's even starting to turn a bit purple there on Jack's leg.
Yeah. Final 30 seconds.
30 seconds left of this first fight in our Roots Muay Thai 8-man.
At the end of this fight, they get that massive adrenaline dump where they go, whoa, I've got to do that again.
Yeah. So it'd be a tricky thing to do. You know, we were just talking about the benefit of having the extra break, but I guess that's a double-edged sword, isn't it? You don't want to just cool down too much and start seizing up.
You do need to stay active, yeah. Out the back, they'll generally keep hitting pads a little bit and shadow boxing to keep moving. Rest enough and then get back out there warming up.
What an absolute stunning fight of our 8-man.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's, I feel sorry for both of them.
Yeah. You would have loved to see both boys continue on through this because that was just sensational.
For sure. Replay, you can see at points Jack pushing forward and wearing shots for it, but then the same thing happens the other way. Josh goes to score and gets scored on. Both very, very talented boys.
Yeah.
About to go to the final.
Some of that before Pinky has just brought it. It's brought a smile to my face.
We've had, ladies and gentlemen, we come to a result here by a unanimous decision and moving on to the semi-finals of the 8-man eliminator, the blue corner, Jack Matthews!
Nothing to be sad about them losing that fight. That was an absolute cracker.